So just going to start under the movable and just wrestle from here. So just to a takedown, not like a 3 second takedown, just to any type of takedown. One technique you can't go for is this far side trip where you kind of cross the knee. Yep, so everyone understand the drill? Been enjoying teaching the pro class at Absolute St Kilda. It's a very high level group of grapplers, so a lot of really interesting questions.
Keeping his hips real far back and his head is low, so I've got a shitty underhook. So I was going for that same single a lot, but his feet were even like further back, so it's like here and here, right? Is there any way to like, I tried walking in, pulling him up, but I'm kind of giving him my hips at the same time. Is there any way to regain that underhook or like something else from that?
You can try for the more like snatch single style where you drop your head through and just come to the leg. So you don't have to shoot if they're so low. Like I can just drop my head through and it comes to the single leg like that. Yeah, it doesn't have to be a shot.
Yeah.
The shot's more effective, but if their leg's too far back, you can just drop that head through and reach around.
So my head just comes here.
Yeah, exactly.
Let's say I've come up through dogfight and I've come up with a body lock. Tom's pulled me up and I realise I have really bad hip position. I'm about to get thrown. I'm probably not going to recover hips in time. Do I have a late stage bailout here for me?
Yeah, best to go for, like at this point it's kind of like a battle for who can get their leg from.
Yeah.
You want to try a 7 and go for
it. Is there a point like where I'm like long, so I've, like, I've come up and I've realised, oh shit, I'm almost here. Yeah.
So if you're behind, your only option is just to...
Okay. I can't.
Yeah.
That's
the
battle.
Okay.
I find it's like a very unique sport, the ADCC rule set. So like there's a lot of, I guess like unexplored areas of like the way wrestling and jiu-jitsu merge.
So the next one we're gonna go through is if they've shot, they're still on the knee, and you find that they're very stiff, like I can't move his head around, he's really tight on my leg. So we're going to do another technique where you slip the corner, but this time it's going to be on the floor. So all I'm doing is I'm stepping my left leg up and around. I'm sitting to my right hip as I get like a crotch hold. So I step, sit the corner, and get a crotch hold. From here, I want to pull myself in, and then I'm going to throw him over my head. So one hand is through his legs, one hand's over the top. I'm going to pull him backwards, and then throw my right hand up, and then land on top. So I pull him, throw my left hand out, and then just land on top. So again, he shoots in. I can't do the first technique we did. He's really stiff and strong on my leg. So rather than try to pull the head to the inside, I'm going to step my left leg to the outside, sit my hips through, get to a crotch hold position, and then I'm going to throw him over my shoulder. When I throw him, I want to land my chest on the mat. Like I don't want to roll onto my own back. I want to throw my right hand out, keep throwing my left hand, and then just come on top. So one more time. So he shoots the single leg, step the corner, slip the hip, throw him over his head, throw my right hand down, and then come on top. Any questions with this one, guys?
Yeah. pretty hard to get up on that leg.
Yeah, for sure. But that's because if he stays low, that's when you can step your... Yeah. And then try and get that in.
Yeah, exactly.
It's fine. Or if he keeps his... Go over. He keeps his elbow tight. And you can go high, you go high elbow here. And obviously the back taking. I think he's feeling the hands off the back.
We're going to the pocket.
Yep. The problem is that we weren't really freeing this knee, we were like focused on trapping this leg.
Yeah, that's right.
Yeah. So that they can't actually.
Yeah. But there's nothing stopping us then from going. So if you.
So like through that. Exactly. Then once they're up here already.
Ah, yeah, that's right.
So you kind of almost want to exaggerate that roll so they have a chance to probably kick over. Yeah. Get to there, kind of roll, do this. You probably want to take the over before I can kick. Finish.
I can't even like get in because he's like moving side to side. He's keeping his knees and he's like big facing me.
Yeah.
Like even if I step in, he's grabbing.
Where do you want it? Where is your hand?
Either inside here or like with Levi style, yeah. Getting to like.
You've got to beat the layer of the feet before you go further.
Okay.
If it's someone on their back, like you can use your hands, but. I eventually want my hands to control the knees, so I usually will use my hands to try to control the shins. Foot pegs over.
Yeah.
Now the knee. Now see how he can't get that line of the foot back. Because now I can hold the knee one. Stop it. If I just here, I can just retract his foot back.
Okay.
But I usually try to like something like this.
Okay.
Now I can start to just move in here. I'm trying to get from the knee to the hip now with a similar
idea. Ankle to the bar.
Yeah. One hip. Obviously you can go. Yeah, you can go left and right as well. That's another way to try to like get in and close the gap to some degree. Or just trying. But yeah, otherwise I try to just open a little space and step in.
Runs. It's very heavily focused on ADCC, so it's a really good session. What else do you want me to say?
Joe Mama.